I own a few mechanical controllers. They all seem to be geared towards a specific category of gamer. The ones I own have arcade-style micro-switches in them and are geared towards fight game enthusiasts. This one is suffering from a bit of an identity crisis because I'm not exactly sure what it's trying to be. How's it going, guys? I'm Gamehead Ness, and today I'm going to be taking a look at the H510 by Sunway Tech, a wireless mechanical gaming controller for the Nintendo Switch. It's also compatible with Android as well as PC. The packaging for this thing is super simple, and inside the box you have the controller itself as well as a set of instructions. That's all that it came with. It didn't even come with a USB Type-C cable for the rechargeable battery, which according to the paperwork should give you between 11 and 19 hours of gameplay. The design is modeled more after the Xbox gamepad style, and it has four face buttons, two analog sticks, a weird protruding 8-directional D-pad, it has a plus, minus, capture button, a center button which serves as a home button, as well as four shoulder buttons. The triggers claim to be magnetic sensors, but honestly, they feel pretty loose and kinda cheaply made. And with the four face buttons, instead of going with arcade-style micro-switches, these are kinda similar to what you would find on a mechanical keyboard. Only they don't feel as durable and are not as clicky. The D-pad, on the other hand, is more in tune with what you would see on a fight pad. It inputs in 8 directions and is nice and clicky, which confuses me a little bit about this controller and why I stated that I feel like it has an identity crisis. Because the directional pad appears to be aimed towards fighting games, but its overall structure seems to be geared towards being a daily driver. While using this controller for the Nintendo Switch, I was really having a hard time finding what it does well. It's definitely comfortable to hold, and the analog sticks really aren't so bad. But I felt that no matter what genre of game I was trying to play, it just constantly felt awkward. It doesn't have amiibo support or gyro controls, nor does it have HD rumble. It does have rumble, however, it's one of those really awkward, very strong vibrations. It felt more like I was holding an electric shaver than I was a game controller, which was very annoying over time, and I found myself just turning rumble off for any game that I was playing. I will say the directional pad felt outstanding while playing a fighting game. However, the awkward design of the face buttons made it really uncomfortable. Timing multiple inputs for certain combos just felt really odd with the way that the buttons protrude. I really wanted to like this controller, but I just could not find one thing that it did exceptionally well. So the H510 by Sunway Tech. Honestly guys, I'm gonna have to say pass on this one. It's something unique and very different, something we're not accustomed to seeing, but I feel like it's different for the sake of being different. While it doesn't perform specifically poorly in any one area, it doesn't perform exceptional in one area either. It's just kinda there. In terms of third-party controllers for the Nintendo Switch, I feel that there are much better options out there. But if you guys are interested in the H510, I will put a link in the description below. Until next time, this is Ness, signing out.